Everyone again, it's a pleasure to take you further on the journey with me into the treasure house of God. Wearing to what God, what David has said in Psalm 31, God has treasures laid up for us, prepared for us to make it a part of our life. Listen to what Psalm 31:19 says, how great is your goodness, which you have stored up for those, which you have prepared for those who take refuge in you. Let's look closely to the words, how great is your goodness. This is not just something small put away for us. It talks about a goodness that is powerful to fulfill any situation and problems and circumstances that might be there to bring you down or to overcome you. Oh no, this goodness consists of the glory of God that is found in the treasure house of God to make you come out on top every time. That's what Deuteronomy 28 says, you're the head and not the tail. With all the blessings falling in this book stored up for us in the treasure house of God. We read Deuteronomy 28, the Bible says, the Lord command the blessings upon thee in thy storehouse. Remember Psalm 31, it's put away up for those prepared, for those, that's us. Praise God. Galatians 3:29 says, and if ye be in Christ, then you are Abram's seed and heirs according to his promise. We read in the book of Peter, which we last week spoke about, of the riches of the blessings of God, which he has stored up for us there. I then brought the scripture from the book of the Song of Solomon, written in chapter 2, to illustrate the fullness we have prepared for us according to Psalm 31. He said, I sat down under his shadow with great delight. And his fruit was sweet to my taste. He brought me to the banqueting house, and his banner over me was love, and to protect and to comfort me. The words I sat down under his shadow indicated the perfect rest of peace that can be found in his presence. Then in the book of Solomon, he goes further and says, under his shadow, that we also spoke of, the complete protection we have in the storehouse of a God for us. As of Psalm 63 says, for you have been my help, and in your shadow of your wings, speaking about the protection, we will rejoice. The word shadow in scripture denotes protection. In Christ, we have abounding joy. That's what we're going to talk about tonight. We learn this from the words in verse 3 with great delight, talking about how the bride feels as she sits with her beloved. Surely, she is filled with joy and delight with his presence there. Psalm 16:11 says, thou wilt show me the path of life, and in thy presence is fullness of joy. At thy right hand there are pleasures forevermore. The joy the Bible is talking about here is a joy which is supernatural and is experienced even in the midst of trials and testings. Look at what the Bible says in Acts 16, where Paul and Silas was in jail and kept as hostages. It says, when they had laid many stripes upon them, they cast them into prison, and at midnight. Now, let's stop there for a few minutes. Hear this. When the Bible talks about the midnight hour, it's always indicating an hour of the utmost darkness, where there seems to be no outcome, and all is lost. Isn't it sometimes something that we sometimes also experience when things go wrong and there seems to be no way out, then it's dark. But the text goes further, it says, and at midnight, Paul and Silas prayed and sang praises unto God. When they did that, something started to happen. The Bible says everything was shaken. When God steps in, nothing can stay the same. Listen, prison doors went open. Everyone's bands were loosed. What happened? Paul and Silas went to the treasure house of God, where there is a fullness prepared to use for situations like they were in. They just stepped into the provision God has prepared for them, the joy of the Lord. And because they knew the joy of the Lord is our strength. What does Psalm 40 says, and I'm closing with this. He drew me out of a horrible pit, a dark time, and set my feet upon a rock, steadying my steps and established my goings. And he put a new song in my mouth and a song of praise of God. He said in Psalm 34, I will bless the Lord all the time. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. The treasure of the house of God is open. Who wants to go and have God open the prison doors and to change situations all the time. Take the joy of the Lord. Start to praise and worship Him. And the way maker, the miracle worker, the promise keeper will set you free. Next week, we will talk of the bountiful supply which is stored up for us in the treasure house of God for you. God bless you. Amen.